Hello, welcome pen friends. I'm back making videos, and today what it is an ink profile of the Ferris Wheel Press Bluegrass Velvet. They have three inks, and I'm going to show you a panel in a minute with the other two and this one. But what I thought I would do real quick as we begin is we'll start the bath test on this ink so that we can see what happens when it does get exposed to water and covered with water. That's what I normally do. It's kind of interesting. You know, at first I thought it might get a little boring, but it really isn't. I like to see what happens, and there's some viewers that like to, too. So there's that. And then just a quick mini report. You know, right before Christmas, we finished up the ink journal, the ink flight for December. And this is the result of Ink Journal's Holiday Blend Candy Cane. The result was I ended up liking that ink so much that I continued writing with it, and it's gone. I mean, I guess I could get a paintbrush in there, but that's about it. So it's kind of like, yay, I finished it, and it was excellent ink. I loved it. So there's that. Okay, so I've got a lot today because I wanted to show you the four pens before we get started that I used with this ink. And what I did was I've got it in my Serendipity Hybrid, and this is the pen I always use. This is my standard. It's got a broad YOWO nib on it. And this is for newcomers, because I know most of you that follow me know this is my standard testing pen for everything I get. And then I'm also using my Lamy Vista with a fine nib on it. And these Lamys are becoming some of my favorite pens. I didn't feel that way about them for the first year. It's taken me over time and switching nibs and getting used to which inks love these drier, you know, Lamy nibs. And that's a generalization, but I really am loving my Lamys. I've got only three. I say only. That's ridiculous because I could change the nibs, but I'm becoming like, I think it's in a tie for my favorite brand. So that surprised me. Okay, and then this is my most beautiful pen. This is my Heinz Custom Blue Storm. And I don't have anything else like it in my collection that compares. And on here, I've got a fine YOWO nib that won't come out. But that's okay, because we, you know, so far I haven't even been able to get it out. But it's a wonderful nib. I just love the pen so much, I'd like to use a different nib. But okay, but that's finer than the Lamy Fine. So, and then we have this, Moonman Mini with a glass nib. And I've been having a lot of fun with this. In one of the notebooks, you're going to see this. So I just thought, for anybody who hasn't been here regularly, especially, these are the pens, and this is the ink. But let's get right in and look at what I did. I made a mini panel so you could see. These are the three inks that this company, Ferris Wheel Press, which is out of Canada, it's a recent Kickstarter. So they, you know, they kind of completed the Kickstarter in November, and they sent out the ink in early December. And so people have the ink now, and they're still selling it. I'm going to link you all of that information, because it's just a little bit complicated. You go to their ferriswheelpress.com, and then you end up clicking, and you go to indiegogo.com, and you can purchase the ink. So, but this is the color we're doing today, the Bluegrass Velvet. And I absolutely love it. And big thank you to pen friend Manda, who sent these two in sample form for me. I bought this in the bottle, which leads me into the next segment, which is the packaging on this ink is really terrific. But, of course, it goes well beyond that. But this is the packaging on the Tanzanite Sky. So this isn't the one we're doing today. But just so you can see it, those who haven't already seen it. And I'll link you to my video on Tanzanite Sky. This is the purpley blue, the first one there on the little chart. That's the first one. I did that ink profile not even realizing that I would eventually have, you know, samples of the other two to profile. I'm thrilled about this. So it comes in this wonderful kind of reminiscent of the old powder containers my mom used to have. You know, it comes in there, and the ink is inside this nice little drawstring bag with their logo and everything on it. And then the bottle itself is just amazing. I love it. It looks like almost like a Christmas ornament. But what I really love is this, the nut cap there. It's just really cool, or bolt or whatever. I get those two terms mixed up. But it's a nice heavy one. it goes on really well. The threading is perfect. And it just, I don't know, it's very unique. In fact, this is what I believe. I believe that I don't have anything that comes close except my J.R. Bond 1798 ink, where I'm just crazy about the bottle and hope I never break it and want it, you know, permanently in my collection like that. So, okay. But trust me, this ink goes far beyond packaging. And we'll start right in the Rhodia Gold Book. This is my ink journal and where I start everything. And I've taken to showing you these chromatography strips kind of soon because I tend to forget. They're small and they get lost. But here it is. Whoops. I've got one more strip left, which is really lucky for me because if I don't mess it up, then that'll give me one for the Candy Marsala. And then if I'm going to continue with these strips, I'll need to purchase some. Also, I may try again with the coffee filters now that I understand the concept better. Thank you, Ink Journal, for sending these in the December box. So, okay, so here it is. Here's where I started. And I devoted a whole page, and I'll do the same for the Candy Marsala. So, this is a mixture of two pens. Where it's broad, it's my broad Yowo nib, and I showed you the Serendipity. And then I was also testing out the Lamy with the fine nib. So here it is back in the broad again. It's a little mixture, but hopefully you can tell. I didn't write with the other pens in this notebook, but I'll show you the ones I did. So I'm really impressed with this. I love this color. And when we get to comparing the colors, you'll see that I got fooled by this. I thought I had something exactly like it, and I'll show you that in a minute. But, you know, it's available. They're mentioning the fact it's 43 Canadian, 32 US for a bottle. And, you know, I'll link you directly to that. They're saying that it'll ship out in January. That's right now. That's the current thing that's being said. As I'm taping this, it is December 27th. So, 2018. So, keep in mind, you might want to check on that if you're watching this in the future. My first impressions are, I can now understand why I had so much hard time deciding between the Tanzanite Sky and the Bluegrass Velvet. It took me forever to decide. I pulled out all of my samples and my ink swatches, and I really went nuts, but I thought I had this color covered better, and we'll see that on the other panel, but and I'm not at all disappointed that I got the Tanzanite Sky, because that's a much more, it's a more complex ink, and for art, it really gives something special, like you've never seen before. So anyway, there's that. Okay, so now let's get into the next notebook. Let's go ahead and look in the Cafe Note by Nanami Paper Company. Oh, no. Okay, I'm back. Anybody who does videos probably knows that it becomes Grand Central the minute you press record. So here we are. I'm really wanting to get this. This is the Cafe Note by Nanami Paper Company. It has Tamoy River paper in it, and it is 7mm line grid. So over here on the left is with this is the Bluegrass Velvet with the broad nib, and then this is with the fine nib. Oh, and the 2 pounds that I somehow gained, probably water weight, are gone now. They're gone. So that was just a fluke. Okay. So I really loved it in the broad nib, but I felt it held up really well in both of the fine nibs. And you know that the Yowo fine nib is a little bit finer than the Lamy, but this is the Lamy fine nib. No, I'm telling you wrong. This is the Heinz Custom. Okay, good thing I labeled this. Okay, I wanted to make sure this held up. I saw that it did in the other notebook. This is the Heinz Custom with the fine Yowo nib, but look at that. That is much finer than the Lamy, and it did just fine in my opinion. It's sometimes hard to compare them because we're talking about two different kinds of paper, too. I guess I could have written both places. But, and this paper here tends to make everything look brighter. It stays on top of that paper. But I was happy with both. In fact, it's going to be really rough. I'm not going to want to clean out any of these pens. I mean, the Serendipity, that's a quick clean out. But I'm not going to want to get the... I'm going to have to decide between the Heinz and the Lamy which one stays. And then I'll pick another pen for the next review because I'm really not... I'm wanting to write with this, like, all the time. And I have, you know, some ink left. And it's just so nice. It was such a generous sample. I'm going to be able to write with it for a while. Okay, so in the Nemesine, this is where we get to really see what the ink looks like color-wise in sort of a swatching kind of process. It's got a lot of red sheen, which surprised me. I didn't see that come out anywhere else, but it did on this paper. I'm not sure if you can see that. It came right out. And yeah, this was all in the Moon Man Mini Glass Nib. I've been writing with this ink for a couple of days, so... that it gives me just a little pause because if it's 2 or 3 days, I get a little rusty on what I was doing. But definitely, I always make a note. So that was the Moon Man Mini Glass Nib. And I really liked it in that. Okay, so let's look at some paper samples too because that gives us a little extra knowledge about the ink. Here's the Tomoy River 52 gram. And I wrote in all three and labeled them. So... at the top, we have the broad Yowo nib. Then in the middle, we have the Lamy fine nib. And then we drop down to the Yowo fine nib in the Heinz Custom. And, you know, you can see that gradual change as we get finer. But I really like how it holds up, and it looks so good in my cheaper notebooks, even in the definitely the real fine nib. In fact, I think it would look good... and my extra fine loom. So I'm going to try it in that, depending on if I have enough, but I think I will. So, okay, and it was just all across the board. I liked the results on the writing test. This was the Leuchtturm 1917 dot grid. You know, it's the same lineup, the broad nib, the Lamy fine nib in the middle, and then the Yowo fine nib and the Heinz Custom at the bottom. And this paper was real compatible with the ink for sure, the Leuchtturm. And then here we move over to Rhodia dot pad 80 gram paper. Okay, and the broad nib on the top, the Lamy fine nib, and then the Yowo in the Heinz. And I can see the drop, the difference there, but it didn't bother me at all. You're still seeing some nice shading and some nice color coming out. I can see the range of color. I can see the dark and the light in it, and that's what I like. Personally, that's just what I like. Okay, then it's not... this is the CVS caliber filler paper, which I use a lot on certain things. Note-taking, I've got several notebooks I use it for, so I need the data. I need to find out what works on it. It holds up great in the broad nib and the Lamy fine nib. It's still okay, I think, with the Yowo fine nib, and it didn't drag or anything, but... I still prefer it in a broader nib, so probably a medium for me would hit a nice, you know, just for notes or for, you know, certain letters that I write. So, okay, then pardon the mess here because this paper's been through a battle. This is the Office Depot College Rule. It's the back of a really busy testing time, I guess. Here's the broad nib and then the Lamy fine nib and the Yowo fine nib in the Heinz Custom. And again, you know, color-wise, I'm liking it. This is thirsty paper, kind of like the Leuchtturm, so it's nice. I was really pleased with the ink. In fact, oh, now it's on my wish list. Okay, my wish list is kind of long. Okay, here is the result. So this is different. This is disappearing. Very typical fountain pen ink. So let's get the panel. The color comparison panel is, I put it in the middle. And this wasn't because there was a spot. It was because I had a viewer comment that really made a lot of sense to me. You know, mentioning that was nice to have the ink of the day in the middle. So I thought, well, let's try that for a while and see how it goes. Because it puts it closer to more of the inks. And this was really tough for me to figure out what looks like it. When I was making my purchase decision... you know, I was deciding which of these three to get my full bottle when I was supporting the Kickstarter. I thought that I had this covered, so well because I thought that Colorverse Gravity Wave was going to be identical. Like, I thought it was so much alike. But it is actually darker. It's more saturated, which is okay. But this is just awesome because you're getting more of that bright blue without it being too light. And so what I realized was, not really. I don't really have anything just like it. The other surprise in this was it really looked more like the Emerald of Chivor than I thought. You know, it's got, it, you know, you can obviously see that it's not exactly the same, but I was excited about the similarity. This has been on my wish list for a long time, but the only one I reach for all the time that's shimmer ink is the Amethyst D. Laurel. There's something about how well that writes on all my paper with my Lamy and everything. So I don't know if this will turn out to be exactly the same, but I'm going to get another sample to see and be, you know, when I first got samples of this Emerald of Chivor, I was too new to understand comparing things. And, you know, now I've been 2 years, I've tested a lot of inks, I kind of know what to do. But so I didn't have much that came in close except for the Pilot Orochi Zuku Kujaku. Very similar, but yet it's different. There's a different tone there to that blue. And then the Monte Grappa Turquoise, I believe, is quite a bit lighter. But then, like, these are two that I really like. I've used two of these Emerald of Chivor samples that were, well, there was only 2 mil in each one, but I used every drop. I mean, I could barely get that out of the bottom of the little vial I had left. So, and some of these just don't even look like it, but they help us to understand how much darker than the Diamine Marine. And also the Diamine Aqua Lagoon, in some of the ink journal notes, I felt like this was very similar, but then when you really get it side by side, no, it's this is much more turquoise, and this has got a deeper look to it. Yeah. So, okay, just one thing left that I wanted to show you was a little bit of spatters here and there on this one little piece that I did. I got a couple. Wow, I buried things. Oh, that's too bad. Well, this was where I put the dabs down first, and I wanted to get a better look at what happened. And that was really neat, the shading and the how light it could get and how dark it could stay. So that's the reverse of the Nick Stewart process, where you put down your water first, and then you start doing drops and introducing your pen and... but, you know, I liked it, but it just wasn't anywhere near as complex as the Tanzanite Sky. So, actually, in retrospect, I think I'll try to get all three on here. So I'll do another one with the Tanzanite Sky, and I'll do the next ink review, which will be the Candy Marsala. But this is really fun, and it's ongoing, because I know today I've got specifically two, a card and a letter I want to get out today that are going to be with the Bluegrass Velvet. And so I'm not really ready to clean my pens yet, but it will be soon that I'll come back with, gosh, and I thought I had another, I'm sure I do, but I have buried the other, I had another one like this that was prettier, and I felt like I already showed it, but it's gone now. That's too bad. I'm going to dig just real quick and see if I just, no, I didn't even, well, that's too bad. Anyway, wow, I get rusty if I'm one day between these videos. This is next. So if you're wondering what's next for ink profiling anyway, it's going to be the Candy Marsala. But I have a notebook that I'm going to probably take advantage of all these inked up pens, and I'll come back with a notebook review, which may come out before the Candy Marsala ink profile. Hopefully this video will be usable with a phone ringing and... lots of little glitches, but it's okay. You know what I've been having fun doing? I've been having fun watching other people's videos, because there's a couple of people that I watch who are right now have more time to make videos, and it's the opposite with me, but it's been really fun to just kind of, you know, use some of my leisure time to watch some other YouTube videos relating to nothing to do with what I'm doing, because... you know, they're pens that I haven't even explored yet and may never, but I love seeing reviews, so it's been a lot of fun. So I'll see you next time. Thank you for hanging in there with me. And we'll come back with Candy Marsala and the notebook review. Okay? Bye for now.